Hello dear students, welcome back in our science session or in our science period. So in our last science period, we have started our new lesson and the name of our lesson is what? Food and digestion. Okay. So in this lesson, food and digestion, on the last period, we have started to see the different nutrients. Nutrients means what? The substances which are needed to our body for the proper growth and the proper health. Okay. So like that, there are the basically five main nutrients that are carbohydrate, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals. Among these five basic nutrients, we have already discussed about the carbohydrates, proteins and fats. So in today's video, we are going to for the further nutrient that we are going to discuss about the vitamins and minerals. Okay. So vitamins and the minerals, these are also the nutrients which are required by our body. So let's discuss about the first, that is what? Vitamins. So the vitamins, these are the nutrients which are required by our body in a very small quantity. But my dear students, you have to keep in the mind that since the vitamins requires in a very less quantity, but it plays a very important role in our body. It plays a vital role in our body. Why? Because these vitamins helps our body to fight against different diseases. Okay. With the help of the vitamins, we can fight, or our body helps to fight the different diseases. Okay. So in this way, that is the reason these vitamins are called as protective food. Okay. Vitamins are called as protective food. Why it is called as protective food? Because vitamins help us to fight against different diseases. They give the energy to our body to fight against different diseases, and that is the reason the vitamins are called as protective food. So there are so many different foodstuffs, and very important thing is that these vitamins mostly we can get from the plant products, and some vitamins we can get from the animal products also. So we can get the vitamins from the different fruits, vegetables. Also we can get the vitamins from the fish, okay, milk, cheese, ghee, all these are there. In that not, we can get the different types of the vitamins. Also we can get the vitamins from the sprouted seeds. Okay, now the sprouted seeds, see in the image what is meant by the sprouted seed. So we have to soak some seeds into the water. We have to keep it overnight. Then you have to tie it in one close. Then the small white structure come out from the seed. That seeds we can call as what? Sprouted seeds. That the sprouted seeds are rich in the vitamins. If you want to increase the vitamins in your body, then you should must have the sprouted seeds in your daily food. Okay, so this is about what? Vitamins, which is called as protective food. Now we'll move on to the next one nutrient, that is nothing but what? Minerals. So like the vitamins, minerals are also called as protective food. Okay, why? Because the minerals are helpful to our body. They also helps to keep our body safe from the germs and the diseases. And also very important, these minerals helps to keep our bones strong. So in this way, what we can say, the minerals are useful to keep our bones strong, to keep our teeth strong. Also this mineral helps to form the blood in our body. So in this way, minerals are necessary to keep our bone, teeth strong and to form the blood in our body. Okay. So which are the different minerals? See here, I have written some names like minerals like calcium, potassium, sodium, iron and iodine. These are the some minerals which are necessary for our body. So this calcium is helpful to keep our bones strong, or we can say to keep our teeth strong. Okay. So this calcium is necessary to keep our bones and the teeth strong. And from which things we are getting this calcium? Calcium we are getting from milk, curd and paneer. So all these are the food material which are rich in the calcium. So they are the rich source of the calcium. Next one is there, that is what? Iron. So this iron is very necessary to form the blood in our body. So the formation of the blood is takes place in the presence of the iron. And which food material is rich in the iron? So we, if you want to increase the iron in our body, iron mineral in our body, then we should include the green leafy vegetables like spinach, carrot in our diet, that which are rich in the iron. Okay. This way we have to eat the spinach, green leafy vegetables, apples or different fruits and the carrots to enhance the availability of the iron in our body. Why? Because the iron helps to form the blood. Next one is that is what? Iodine. Okay, so iodine is also very important, and this iodine mostly we are getting from the salt that we are adding in our food material. Okay, so iodized salt we have to use to take the proper iodine in our body. And my dear students, very important, if there is a lack of iodine in our body, if there is a less amount of iodine present in our body, then one should get suffer from the one diseases, and the name of that disease is nothing but what? Goiter. The name of that disease is what? Goiter. What is the goiter? You can see in the image how it is exactly goiter. So in this neck region there is one gland, that is what? Thyroid gland. The thyroid gland get increase in the size, and that disease is called as what? Goiter. Okay, so to avoid the goiters, we have to include the iodine mineral in our diet. So this is about vitamin and minerals, which are called as what? Protective food. Okay, now the next one, along with all these five nutrients, along with carbohydrate, protein, fats, vitamins and minerals, our body also requires the enough amount of roughage and water. Okay, roughage and water. So let's discuss what is mean by roughage. Roughage is the fiber present in the food atoms that we get from plant. Okay, so roughage is a fibrous atom. Okay, that is present in the food material. And very important thing is that these roughage we are mostly or we are getting from the plants only. The roughage we can get from the plants only. Okay. So now my dear student, now which season is going on? Summer season. And if you talk about the summer season, then the first thing comes in our mind, that is nothing but what? Alfonso mango. Okay. So we are having the mango. After eating the mango, some thread-like structures get stuck in our teeth. That is nothing but what? Fibers. Okay, that is nothing but what? Fibers. And as we know, mango we are getting from the plants. Okay, so in this way, what we can say, we have to include the fibrous substances in our body. Okay, so the roughage is the fibrous substance present in the food atoms that we get from the plant. Okay, so see here, roughage we cannot digest, our body cannot digest the roughage. But still it is important. Why? Because this roughage help us our body to throw out the undigested food from our body. Okay, so very important sentence, roughage cannot get digested by the human body, but it helps to throw out the undigested food from our body. Okay, so this is about what? Roughage. Now the next one we are going to see about what? Water. Okay, which is very important. We have to drink the enough water within a day. Okay, why? Because the water plays an also very important role in the process of the digestion. We know that 3/4 of our body weight is because of the presence of the water, or we can say that what? 70% of our body weight is because of the water. 70% of our body is full of water. Okay, so this water is useful to absorb or to dissolve the digested food, also to dissolve the waste. This water is helpful to digest, dissolve and to absorb the food. Okay, what is the use of the water? Water helps for the digestion. After that, what happens? If the food gets digested in the water, and also it absorbs the digested food also. So water helps in the process of digestion, also the absorption and the digestion of the food material. Also very important, this water helps to remove the unwanted materials from our body in the form of urine and sweat. Okay, so unwanted means what? The material which are not necessary for our body. So that materials are throwing out from our body. Okay, the materials like what? Urine. Okay, the materials like what? Urine and sweat. Okay, the materials, unwanted materials, that is what? Urine and the sweat we are throwing out from our body. And to throw that materials, which thing helps our body? That is nothing but what? water. Okay, so the water helps to throw out the unwanted material from our body, that are urine and sweat. Okay, so we should drink more and more water for within a day. We should drink the 8 to 10 glasses of the water, or 1 to 3 liters of the water every day. Okay, so this is about what water. So now, up till now, we have discussed about the nutrients, roughage, and water. Now we are going to see the next one, that is balanced diet. Before going to see the balanced diet, we will discuss about what is mean by diet. So diet means what? Whatever the food we are having within a day, okay, or within a whole day, whatever the food we are having, that food material, that food stuff is called as what? Diet. But our diet should be balanced. Our diet should be balanced. Now let's see what is mean by then balanced diet. Okay, a diet. Diet means what I said. Whatever the food material we are having within a day, that all the food stuff is called as what? Diet. But the diet should contain a different nutrients. Okay, a diet that contains proper amount of, okay, what? The diet that contains proper amount of all the nutrients. Okay, so our food item or our diet should contain all the amount, all the types of nutrients. Along with that, roughage and water required for good health is called balanced diet. So the diet which require, or the diet that contains proper amount of all nutrients. Okay, the diet which contains proper amount of all nutrients, and also it contains roughage and water which are required for our good health, then that diet is called as what? Balanced diet. Okay, then that diet is called as what? Balanced diet. That is the reason we should eat the different types of the food materials, and because different types of the food material uses different types of the nutrients. Okay, for example, we can say that leafy vegetables uses more amount of the iron. Then we have, if we have every time all the leafy vegetables, then we will get only iron. But what about the other nutrients? What about carbohydrate, proteins and all that? That is the reason our diet should contain some amount of protein, carbohydrate, fats, vitamins, minerals. Along with that, our food should contain roughage and water too. Okay, then only our diet becomes what? Balanced diet. So this is all about today. Today we have discussed about vitamins, minerals, roughage. Also we have discussed about water and balanced diet. Okay, so this is all about today. Today's your homework is that you have to read all these points from the textbook. So this is the time to tell you goodbye. We will stop here. We will meet in the next video with the next point. And for today, thank you.